Hi, I'm Mike Hymos. I'm the Stormwater Educator for the City of Columbia. I'm here to talk to you today about some best management practices you can do around your home. In Columbia, when it rains, it drains. And what I mean is all the rainwater that lands on our pavement, on our driveways, and in our yards, and on our roofs, all drain to the same location, through city storm drains. And those storm drains are all connected to places like this. It's important to remember the pesticides, the chemicals, the leaky oil from your car, the carcinogens from cigarette butts, all the things that go down the drain all end up here. And this is where we get our drinking water. One of the easiest things you can do around your house is to let your grass grow a little taller than you used to. Most people like that clean-shaven golf course look, but unfortunately with our grasses here in Missouri, it's better to let them grow a little higher. Most places recommend that you grow them at least 3 inches height, which means raising your lawn more higher than maybe you're used to, but it also helps cut down on the use of pesticides, herbicides, and fertilizers, and will also crowd out the weeds that may sprout up and grow. Another common thing we see around Columbia, which most people do, when they're cutting their grass, they let their grass clippings blow into the street and the curb. This doesn't seem like a common problem, but actually it is. For most people, they consider it unsightly, but it has a greater effect than you think. These grass clippings will eventually wash their way and work their way down to the storm drain, which is great. They're gone. They're not in your yard anymore. They're not on the street. But the problem with that is all that extra grass clippings, all that extra leaves, all the things that you blew into the street to wash down the storm drain eventually end up in the creeks and in the streams. Well, the issue with that is all the extra algae that creates, and that creates what we call algae blooms. And that's where there's an overabundance of algae from all the dead material that's not normally there, but put there by us. And what that does is it causes dead zones within the creek. And as the leaves and as the grass decays, it slowly sinks down to the bottom of the creek bed, and it chokes off all the oxygen for all the animals that live within that creek or in that stream. Pet waste, as it slowly decays, has all sorts of microorganisms. Those organisms come right off the waste and drain right down the yard, right into the street, right into the gutter, and right into the storm drains. It's very important to make sure that we clean those up, because just like the grass clippings, all that extra animal waste has different microbes, different bacteria, extra nitrogen, extra components to our stream and creek water, and it becomes lethal for the habitat that lives there. Fertilizer actually adds extra nitrates to the water, which is almost the same as when we leave our grass clippings in the street. The extra fertilizer, when you're spreading it, especially if you're using a spreader, will throw out the extra nitrogen, which is good for growing the grass and for plants. They need that, but actually it's not good for our streams and our creeks. If you're going to fertilize your lawn, we recommend that you first get your soil tested, make sure that you use the appropriate amount, and also if you get any on the street, please sweep it back off, pick it up, or sweep it back into the yard. We'd like to remind people to take their household hazardous waste, such as old motor oil, old paint, old antifreeze, the HHW, the Household Hazardous Waste Collection Site, located at the Grissom Building. Collection starts in April and goes to November and is on the first and third Saturday of every month. Remember, these chemicals are hazardous, and we do stress. Please dispose of them properly and do not dump them down a storm drain. Something I'd like to remind folks is this. Whether you're on the University of Missouri campus, whether you're in the City of Columbia, downtown or out in the subdivisions, whether you're in the county, all storm drains drain to our creeks and streams. They are not hooked up to a wastewater facility plant. Storm drain water goes directly to our creeks and streams. It is not filtered, it is not cleaned, so whatever you put on the ground goes there. Those are some of the things that you can do around your house to help keep polluted runoff out of our creeks and streams. But here's some of the things that the City of Columbia is doing.
We're looking at porous pavement here. The City of Columbia has started to work in best management practices, BMPs, to help clean the water and then also to help slow the water down. One of the most damaging effects of a lot of impervious surface is that it speeds the hydrologic response of the watershed and causes water to run off a lot more quickly, and it causes a lot more water to run off. Basically, most of the water that comes off of this site, off of the fire station site, and the water that comes through the porous pavement and water that comes from across the road over there flows into this. This is a bioretention cell. And the bioretention cell has special soil in it, and it's got special plants that do a good job of surviving in this environment. The water sinks through that soil, and as it sinks through that soil and the plant roots and everything, it gets cleaned. Then it flows out through a drain that's on the bottom of the bioretention cell out through this inlet. In a really large rain, a big storm event, the water will actually just overflow this, and it will go out the inlet here in order to prevent flooding.
The City of Columbia is trying to address our stormwater management using various things, best management practices, or BMPs for short, such as pervious pavement, bioretention basins, rain garden like you see here, and other low impact development techniques. This particular rain garden is on Harvard, and it was a way of managing the stormwater for this pavement. The purpose of the rain garden is to slow the water down, reduce runoff, and treat the runoff to remove some of the pollutants from the runoff. All these are part of our stormwater management plan, things that we strive for in our stormwater projects for the city.
Eventually, as we work to retrofit these practices into older neighborhoods, and as newer development takes place and they put these practices in, we should see our streams start to rebound a little bit. We'll have better water quality in the streams, and so there'll be more life in the streams. We'll be able to more comfortably do things in the streams like kayaking or swimming or things like that without having to worry that we're, bathing in pollution.
More information about Columbia stormwater management can be found at gocolumbiamo.com and search Go Stormwater.